So just a quick brief summary of what Sultan has mentioned. You know, it's thanking Aqua Africa as well as the government, local government, bringing the organization here to come and do assessment within the community. As you guys can see behind me, it looks as like there's no one that lives here, but around the surrounding areas here, where we are at currently, it's a church premises. It's a Saint Peter.
Saint Peter.
Okay, so yeah, this belongs to Saint Peter Catholic Church. This is a parish. You guys can see behind the tree there.
The chapel.
That is the chapel is there. On the parishes up by the main road.
Yeah.
And you guys can see behind here, they're constructed another a new
chapel.
The other one there is kind of old now. So basically what you're saying is that for the people that live here, these are farmers. So what they're doing is that they come here and they do their farming here. Some people from the town, they also come here during rainy season, do their farming, dry season, then they will go back. So there's one hand pump that has been here, but it's been broken for over 4 years now, has not been rehabilitated. So for the community to go, they walk about 2 to 2.5 kilometers just to go fetch water from the stream, from the river. And then during dry season, the river dries up, so then there's no way. You have to go all the way to Anzara town to fetch water, or also those that have the ability to purchase water, they have the motorbikes, or they can afford to pay for a vehicle to bring water here for them. So this is the challenge that Sultan has mentioned the community is facing. Again, as we're here conducting assessment, 3 different locations. Again, as we've told Sultan, being transparent with the community, this is 1 of 3 locations. So we're not, Aqua Africa will not be able to do all 3 the same time, 1 year, but God willingly and hopefully we do get the funding or so, then we'll be able to do all 3, inshallah.
Thank you.